What is the differences between VFD and Softstarter? When should we use Softstarter and when should we use VFD? Hey guys, this is Ehsan from PowerEN. Today, we want to take a look at the use of VFD and Softstarter and answer the question of when we should use them. So stay tuned, hit the button and subscribe now. First of all, let's see why should we use VFD and Softstarter at all. Electric motors have many applications in residential, commercial, and industrial buildings. However, motors must have suitable controls and protection to ensure a long service life and correct operation. When motors start at full voltage, the high inrush current and starting torque can shorten their service life. Several starting methods are used to protect motors from this, including Softstarter and variable frequency drives known as VFD. When comparing a Softstarter and a VFD, it is impossible to say that one device is better. A Softstarter is designed exclusively to start motors at reduced voltage. At the same time, a VFD can also control the speed of operating motor. For a given motor horsepower, a VFD is more expensive due to its additional function. Using a VFD for a motor that doesn't require the speed control is a waste of funds. Before we go to VFD and Softstarter, let's take a closer look at the motor starting and see why we need an electric motor starter. A motor starter is a device that is used to safely start and stop an electric motor. Most of the electric motors draw a huge amount of electric current, approximately 8 times its rated current, my god, during the startup due to their low winding resistance. This huge starting current is called inrush current, which can damage the internal winding of the motor and reduce its lifetime and, the worst case, cause burn. The motor starters are used to reduce the starting current, so it can safely start without any damage to its winding or any other mechanical part due to the sudden jerks. It also helps stopping the motor once the power is turned off. They also offer protection against low voltage and overcurrent protection. This is why we need to use a motor starter. Okay guys, let's see when we should use a Softstarter. A Softstarter uses an array of 6 thyristors or silicon control rectifier or SCR to reduce the starting current and torque of 3-phase motor. A thyristor can be described as an electronic valve that only allows current in one direction and only when a control signal is applied. 6 thyristors are needed for 3-phase power since there are 3 AC voltage switch polarity at 60 Hz. For that, 2 thyristors are needed per phase, each for different polarity. When an electric motor uses a Softstarter, the 6 thyristors are used as valves that limit the 3-phase voltage. Instead of applying rated voltage at once, the Softstarter cut part of the voltage waveform and limits both the inrush current and starting torque. The SCR circuit used by Softstarter can limit voltage, but the frequency stays at 60 Hz. Since the speed of running motor depends on frequency, a Softstarter cannot reduce RPM. However, this is not an issue in application where the motor is always used at full speed. Softstarters are helpful when motor drive large load requiring a high current and torque to rotate. These loads include industrial machinery, dust collector fan, and pumping system with a constant flow. Before we go to VFD, take a deep breath and subscribe now. Just kidding, hit the button. Let's see when we should use a variable frequency drive. As I mentioned, a VFD can control both the voltage and frequency applied to an electric motor. This means a VFD can be used as a starter, but it can also reduce speed in application where the motor workload changes. Voltage and frequency control is possible thanks to a 3-step process. Step 1. The AC voltage supply is converted to DC with a rectifier. Step 2. The DC signal is then filtered to improve power quality. And finally, in step 3, an inverter converts DC power back into AC at the required voltage and frequency. Since a VFD controls control both voltage and frequency, it can also adjust the voltage to frequency ratio, which determines torque. Reducing voltage of the running motor will normally cause higher current and overheating, which are detrimental for performance and service life. However, when voltage and frequency are reduced, the electric motor slows down without negative consequences. VFD are useful when motor have variable workload. For example, a VFD can ramp down a building's pump system when water usage is low, or reduce ventilation rates when occupancy is low. In both cases, there is a great opportunity to save energy by adjusting the RPM. Okay friends, in summary, when motors start at full voltage, the high inrush current and starting torque can damage them and other components. Soft starter and VFDs both reduce the inrush current by limiting voltage. Still, there are also significant differences between these devices. Electrical engineers recommend soft starter when motors only need starting system, and VFDs when motors also need speed control while operating. A soft starter cannot save energy by ramping down a motor with variable load. A VFD wasted its speed control capacity when used only as a starter. Well, unfortunately, we have reached the end of this video. I hope the content has been useful for you. Subscribe now to see each other again in the following video. Goodbye.